Our today's topics for the discussion are Introduction to Metal and its Alloys and Physical Property of Metals. Introduction to Metal and its Alloys. First of all, we will see what is the difference between metals and its alloys. Okay. So metals are generally pure metals are those metals that have not been alloyed with other metallic elements. Commercially, pure metals are 99% pure metal, like copper, aluminium, ferrous, zinc, all are known as pure metals. But what is alloys? An alloy is a combination of metal with at least one other metal or non-metal. The combination must be part of a solid solution, a compound or a mixture with another metal or non-metal in order to it to be considered an alloy. So here generally metal is classified in ferrous and non-ferrous metal. Okay, ferrous in which one content is ferrous. Okay, so again ferrous is pure ferrous metal and ferrous alloys. Okay, in pure ferrous metals, the example is iron. Okay, and ferrous alloys means ferrous is added by another metals, like carbon, manganese, phosphorus, etc., then the product of metal become ferrous alloys. This is one example, steel, okay, like stainless steel, then high carbon steel, low carbon steel are the example of ferrous alloys. But in pure ferrous metals, there is only one content, ferrous, and iron is an example for that. Now for non-ferrous metal is again classified into pure non-ferrous and non-ferrous alloys. In pure non-ferrous, the examples are copper, aluminium, zinc, tin, lead, silver, gold and mercury. Mercury is a liquid metal. Okay. And non-ferrous alloys, for example, brass is a non-ferrous alloy, which is a combination of copper plus zinc, in which copper is a major alloy and some part of zinc is added in the copper. Similarly, if you add tin into a copper, then the alloys known as bronze. Solder, in which lead plus tin are the component for that particular alloys. Okay. Non-ferrous metals. We have already discussed that the non-ferrous metals are those which contain metal other than iron and their chief constituent. The non-ferrous metals are usually employed in industry due to the following characteristics. Easy of fabrication means casting, it can be rolling, forging, welding and machining are possible for the non-ferrous metal. Then resistance to corrosion. This is a very important property of non-ferrous metals. It is offered more resistance to corrosion than ferrous metal. Electrical and thermal conductivity and weight. Okay. The various non-ferrous metals used in engineering practice are aluminium, copper, lead, tin, zinc, nickel, etc. and their alloys. Now let us see physical property of metals. So main physical properties are shape, size, color, luster, specific gravity, porosity, structure, and the finishing of the metal. Now, metal consists of an orderly array of ions surrounded by and held together by a cloud of electrons. This is reflected in many of the physical properties of the metals. So, as we discussed earlier, that all the metal in which the metallic bonds are there, and in all the metals in the outermost orbit, there are 1, 2, or 3 electrons which are moving, and that's why the property of the metals are listed here. So let us see one by one. First property of the metal is luster. Okay, the ability of the surface of the material to reflect light, that is known as luster. So as you show in figure, most all the metals are luster in nature, so the light is reflected. It is the property of brightness of the surface of the material, and the property of luster is greatly helpful in classifying a material as metallic or non-metallic. Color. The physical property of material of displaying, showing a particular hue in the normal daylight is known as color. The color of the material is depends upon the wavelength of the line which that material can absorb, and also on the state like solid, liquid, etc. of the material. Specific colors of the metal, for example, yellow color of gold, red is brown color of copper, and so on. So here you can visualize that different material have different colors. Okay, now the important property, density. Okay. As we know that the weight per unit volume of material is known as density. So the equation of the density is weight of the material in kg per volume of material, meter cube. The ratio of the density of material to density of water is known as specific gravity. So most of the metals have higher density than of non-metal. In periodic table of elements, show that the density increases regularly with increasing atomic numbers. So here metals and its density given in kg per meter cube. So iron has a 7850 kg per meter cube density, copper 8960, aluminum has a low density, so that's why it is a light weight. Lead is a very heavy material, density 11,340. Nickel, silver, tin, zinc, and mercury. So mercury has also a high density. So you have to remember the density of mercury, 13,600. Okay. Now, melting point. The temperature at which solid material changes to liquid form is known as melting point. It is expressed in degree Kelvin or centigrade. Melting point of some important metals. So here the melting point is very important, because whenever you manufacture any product from a metal, you must have to heat it and convert it into liquid, and after casting of any product, you can manufacture the required shape and size. So the melting point is very important. Here listed melting point for some metal. So iron has a 1535 degree centigrade, copper 1083, aluminum has low melting point, lead low melting point. So from listed metal we can say the iron has a maximum melting point. Specific heat capacity: the amount of heat energy that will raise the temperature of a unit mass of the material by 1 degree. So the amount of heat change per degree centigrade, so whatever the energy we have given, that is known as specific heat energy or heat capacity. For iron, specific heat 0.109, okay, calorie per gram degree centigrade. Now thermal conductivity. The thermal conductivity of a material is the quantity of heat that passes in unit time through unit area of a plate when its opposite face are subject to unit temperature gradient. Example, 1 degree temperature different across a thickness of one unit. The thermal conductivity is equal to heat flow rate by area into temperature gradient. Thermal conductivity is measured in watt per meter into Kelvin. So iron has 73 value, copper 395, copper 395, aluminum 235, lead 33.5, nickel 63. So from this data we can say that a copper and aluminum have more thermal conductivity. That's why these both materials are very useful in the thermal product. Thermal expansion. The linear coefficient of thermal expansion is defined as the proportional change in a material's length when its temperature changes by 1 degree. So coefficient of linear thermal expansion is equal to alpha is equal to delta L by L into delta T. So here there is one rod of length L0, and if we give the temperature and if you heat the rod, the length of the rod is increased by delta L. Okay. So that property is known as thermal expansion. In railway, you have seen that between two rail there is a gap between these two, because when the temperature of the atmosphere is increased, the length of the rail is also increased. So that is to avoid the chances of accident, we keep the gap between two rail adjoint. Electrical conductivity. Electrical conductivity is the reciprocal of the specific resistance. Most metals are good conductors, while many plastics, ceramic, rubbers, etc. are very poor conductors. Magnetic property. Ferromagnetic materials have high magnetic permeability and therefore can be magnetized by induction. Thank you for watching this video.